This spreadsheet will allow your class to collect data on a variety of conditions and compare graphs across them. Each team will have their own tab. Let's see an example of how to enter data for one of these conditions. The top of each sheet contains two distinct tables, one that students will use on day one of the lesson, and one that students will use on day two of the lesson. Some groups may be doing condition 3 on day 1 and condition 4 on day 2. You may vary this investigation by having each group do only one condition, or each group doing all 4 conditions. But it is important that the class as a whole has access to multiple trials for each one of the 4 conditions by the end of the investigation. Each condition features 2 objects. Each of the objects in a condition has been charged on one side, with the charged sides facing each other. In the first column, students will enter the height to the top edge of the lower object or material. This will likely only need to be measured once for a given condition, as it should remain constant throughout the investigation. Let's say that height is 14 centimeters. In the next column, we will enter another height, from the table up to the bottom of the upper object or material. Let's say that is 14.5 centimeters. The fourth column will then calculate the distance between the charged surfaces of the objects. It does this by automatically subtracting the value in the first column from the value in the second column. Numbers in this column should not be deleted, as that will make the spreadsheet unable to complete this calculation automatically. Another automatic calculation will be made in column 5 when you enter the gram force for each test into the third column. This is the value that is measured on the scale. If you enter a value of 1 gram force, the fifth column multiplies this value by 9.8 to give the force in the units of millinewtons. Once you have entered all data into the tables, you will be able to produce a graph from each table. Let's see how to do that next. You can make a graph from your data by highlighting the columns and rows you want to graph, including the column headings. In this case, you will want to see the graph of the distance between sheets and the force exerted on the scale. Highlight just those columns and not the entire table. Start in the top left corner so that the graph uses the appropriate axes. Then select Insert, Chart. You then need to drag the graph produced so that you have space to see the table. And you'll want to resize that graph so that a second graph can fit next to it. It is suggested that you relabel both graphs so that you and others can more easily keep track of which is which. You do this by clicking on the title and retyping which condition it represents. You may copy this information from the first row at the top of the table that the graph is representing.